ay merong zero accomplishment rate pero sinagot ng ating USEC. Gusto ko sanang balikan yung slide 11 of the presentation, the budget presentation. Yung improving the learning environment and learning resources. Gusto ko lang itong balikan kasi ito po yung listahan ng accomplishments na pinresent ng DepEd. Okay, so how soon will the rest be delivered?
As per the contract, is 180 days hanggang December po of this year, madideliver na natin itong lahat ng 44,638.
6 months?
Yes, ma'am.
From procurement to delivery?
Yes po.
You said, I think that is unacceptable.
Ma'am, kasi ito, kung napapansin nyo, yan pong 44,638, this equates to 504,000 laptops. Kalahating milyong laptops po ang dinideliver natin ngayon, yung na-procured for delivery.
Yes, but will you agree? Okay, wag mo muna akong sabihan ng 504,000. Tanungin lang kita, yung commonsensical, kung ikaw mismo pipili ka, tatawag ka ngayon sa Shopee, pabili po ako ng computer, sinabihan ka ng Shopee, okay, sige po, pero i-deliver ko sa iyo 6 months from now. Tatanggapin mo yon?
Hindi,
ikaw, as an individual?
No po, ma'am.
Oh, okay. In the same vein, hindi rin po papayag ang mga estudyanteng Pilipino. And we all speak on behalf of them. So what's the solution, sir?
Ma'am.
Thank you for the input from no less than the chair of the Committee on Education of the House of Representatives. Before we proceed, the chair would like to acknowledge the presence of Deputy Speaker Duke Frasco. Next to us question is Deputy Majority Leader Bong Teves.
Madam Chair, fellow colleagues, the Department of Education family, headed by the recently appointed Secretary Sanayang Angara, good afternoon to all of us. First of all, I would like to congratulate the Secretary Angara for his well-deserved appointment in the Department of Education. Alam naman po nating lahat na katulad ng kanyang ama, the late former Senate President Edgardo Angara, si Secretary Sanayang Angara ay champion din sa mga pagpasa ng mga batas para sa edukasyon katulad ng pre-college law at student financial assistance law. Currently, ang ating bansa ay nakakaranas ng crisis education dahil based on the report of the World Bank on Global Learning Poverty Program for International Student Assessment of PISA at Trends in International Mathematics in Science Study, ang Pilipinas ay isa sa mga pinakamababang provincial level. Pero ang lahat na yan ay minana lamang ng ating secretary sa former secretary. Ang problema sa laptops, problema sa smart TV ng mga distribution, ay minana rin natin ng ating buting secretary sa nakaraang administrasyong secretary. Ang napakalungkot na COA observation report na binabanggit ng ating kasamang mga minority leaders ay minana rin lamang ito ng ating secretary sa former secretary. But with the Secretary Sunny Angara in the Department of Education, we are now certain that these issues will be addressed immediately. Madam Chair, as a Deputy Majority Leader and TGP Party's representative, I manifest my 100% support to the proposed budget of the Department of Education in we due courtesy to a former senator and fellow legislator in the 19th Congress. I encourage our colleagues in the majority and the minority to support the proposed budget and, if possible, dagdagan pa ang budget ng DepEd to conform with the President Bongbong Marcos Advocacy sa bagong Pilipinas. Sama-sama tayong babangon muli. Maraming salamat po sa inyo lahat.
Maraming salamat, Madam Chair, sa ating kaibigan from TGP, Congressman Bong Teves, Deputy Majority Leader. Maraming salamat po.
Thank you very much, Congressman Teves. Next to interpellate is Representative our Senior Vice Chairperson, Stella Kimbo.
Salamat, Madam Chair. Siguro wag na natin i-congratulate si Sexani mismo, kundi congratulate natin ang buong bansa dahil nagkaroon tayo ng bagong pag-asa dito sa pagharap sa ating napakalaking education crisis. Klaro naman po, malaki yung problema ang kinakaharap natin. Medyo nangungulela tayo pagdating sa buong mundo. Klaro naman po sa PISA rankings. May hirap po yun sa isang sitwasyon na sinasabi nila the world is flat. Ang mga apo natin, mga anak natin, they have to compete globally. So, may mga kabataan ngayon, ang trabaho nila, virtual assistant. Ibig sabihin, they apply online for a job. Ang mga kalaban nila, buong mundo. So, kung nangungulela tayo, hirap sila mag-compete. So, yun ang kinakaharap ng ating kalihim buong kagawaran. So, kailangan natin tulungan ang DepEd. So, having said that, big crisis, we cannot waste funds, we cannot waste time. I think those are the two things. So, nakakalungkot na pagdating sa COA report at pinapakinggan ko ang ibang mga Kongs. Yun ang isa sa pinaka malaking finding ng COA report in 2023, low utilization. Ibig sabihin, mabagal ang paggastos at may natitirang pondo. So, wasted funds, wasted time. Of course, pag i-compare po natin halimbawa sa sinasaad ng liquidation reports ng confidential funds na for 3 quarters na 100% na ginastos for the 3 quarters totaling 112.5 million ginastos po ito for the first quarter, Feb 20 to March 30, for the second quarter, April 20 to June 29, and for the third quarter, July 12 to September 29, for a total of 190 days. And if we count the number of days in three quarters, that's 273 days. So, 190 over 273, that's 69%. So if you divide 100% utilized funds by 69% in terms of days, ang score po nun in terms of efficiency is 143%. So ang efficiency pagdating sa spending ng confidential funds ay 143%. Congratulations po. Pero pagdating naman po sa regular funds, napakabagal po. So, nakasaad po sa COA report 2023, may natira pa pong 37.7 billion at ang sinabi po ay may delayed, partial, at non-implementation of various programs. And with that, sana COMSEC, pwede po bang ilagay ang slide 11 ni Sec Sunny because I want to revisit that slide. Kasi nabanggit nga kanina ni Kong Jinky pagdating sa DCP, yung ating ICT packages, binalikan niya, sinabi niya na ayon sa COA report ay merong zero accomplishment rate pero sinagot ng ating USEC. Gusto ko sanang balikan. Yung slide 11 of the presentation, the budget presentation, yung improving the learning environment and learning resources. Gusto ko lang itong balikan kasi ito po yung lista ng accomplishments na pinresent ng DepEd. Nang naka-indicate is 44,638 ICT packages for delivery. So, kanina po, dinictate ng ating USEC kung ilan na po ang delivered. Tinignan naman po natin, pero hindi pa rin siya nagtatali to 44,000. Pasensya na po ha. For 2023, the total is 11,013. And then for 2024, it's 5,567. So, hindi talaga siya nagtatali to 44,638. So, kasi yun ang tanong ko eh. Kung sinabi ng COA report, as of end 2023, zero delivered. Parang ang galing naman na umabot tayo ng 44,000 today. Of course, kung yan ay na-achieve ninyo, please explain because we will all clap for you. But based on your report, ang layo po nung 5,567 plus 11,013. So are you trying to say that this 44,638, how far are you counting? Is this including your 2015?
It includes procurement? 2022, ma'am. 2022,
but your 2022 is only 10,695, so it still doesn't add up to 44,000. So you must be including those earlier procurements kasi ito po ba yung i-refer natin na nabubulok doon sa warehouses. So please give us an explanation.
Maybe we can ask the same resource person with your permission, Madam Chair.
Yes, yes, please, sir. Alam natin na hindi pa mainit ang inyong upuan. So, yung mga datihan po, please.
You are recognized, Director Pizan.
Blessed day, Your Honor. Ma'am, yung 44,638 packages, this is a combination of the 2023 package, that's 26,692 plus the 2024 package of 17,943.
Madam Chair, I would like to manifest that yung binabanggit po ni USEC ay procured, which is different from delivered. Malaki pong pagkakaiba yun. It's an ocean of a difference. So yun nga po ang sinasabi ng COA. Yung nag-procure po kayo pero hindi delivered, ang delivery ay equals accomplishment. At yun po yung punto ng COA. So sana po, ito po ang i-report ninyo, 44,638, aso procured for delivery.
Yes.
Okay. So, to be delivered. So, pasensya na po, pero yun nga ang point ng COA. Delivery ang pinaka-importante sa lahat. Diba po? And at the same time, may problema po yung natitenga po siya sa warehousing, diba? Sorry. So, pag na-deliver siya sa warehouse, problema pa yung from the warehouse to the school.
Your Honor, for the fund year starting 2022, 2023, 2024, yung 2023 natin, diretso na po ito sa schools. So, wala na pong warehousing sa 2023 fund at 2024 fund. Delivered to schools na po ito. Diretso na po. Yung pong nasa warehouse, yun po yung 2020-2021.
Okay, so how soon will the rest be delivered?
As per the contract, is 180 days hanggang December po of this year, madideliver na natin tong lahat ng 44,638.
How many days?
Hanggang 180 days po ang contract nito, ang contract duration.
Until December 2024, ma'am.
180 divided by 6 months?
Yes, ma'am.
From procurement to delivery?
Yes po.
I think that is unacceptable.
Ma'am, kasi ito, kung napapansin nyo, yan pong 44,638, this equates to 504,000 laptops. Kalahating milyong laptops po ang dinideliver natin ngayon, yung na-procured for delivery.
Yes, but will you agree? Okay. Wag mo muna akong sabihan ng 504,000. Tanungin lang kita. Yung commonsensical, kung ikaw mismo bibili ka, Katawag ka ngayon sa Shopee, pabili po ako ng computer. Sinabihan ka ng Shopee, okay, sige po, pero i-deliver ko sa iyo 6 months from now. Tatanggapin mo yon?
Hindi,
ikaw, ma'am. As an individual?
No po, ma'am.
Oh, okay. In the same vein, hindi rin po papayag ang mga estudyanteng Pilipino. And we all speak on behalf of them. So what's the solution, sir?
Ma'am, in-order kasi ito ng mga suppliers natin sa abroad kasi wala naman pong nagba-burn in ng core sa Philippines. So usually, in-order to sa abroad by bulk din. Pagdating dito, i-assemble pa. So talaga pong merong time allotment para po ma-burn in yung mga technologies.
So,
na.
How many suppliers are you talking about?
Ma'am, ang suppliers natin ngayon, mga 7 to 8 suppliers. We will give you the breakdown.
Is it a matter of increasing the number of suppliers?
Ma'am, open bidding po ito. So kung sino po yung manalo, sa kanila po natin ina-award yung contract.
Director, I'm just telling you, and I think all members will agree with me, that your timetable is completely unacceptable. Kasi ano po ang ano po ba ang useful life ng isang computer?
Ang according po sa COA, 5 years po yung obsolescence.
Ayun na nga po. Eh kung yung 6 months po, is just time for delivery. Tapos ilan buwan pa ang procurement, another 6 months.
Hindi ma'am, yung 6 months na iyon, is yun na yung contract award to delivery. Kumbaga yun yung time na i-deliver nila dapat.
Correct, but that from the time that you put up the bid, etc., it's probably going to take 1 year, right?
Yung ngayon po, mabilis na po tayo. Nagsimula po tayo ng bidding ng January.
Okay, my point being, what is the solution, sir?
We need to do early procurement, Madam Chair. I think itong ginawa nila na pagpapasok na tsaka nag-procure medyo dapat
baka sir hindi kaya pwedeng i-decentralize na lang to how many regional offices do you have, in which case that will increase the number of suppliers.
17 including
and
the
you would have one back per regional office, right? That would mean at least 17 suppliers, and per RO you can have more than one supplier. Is that correct?
That's correct, ma'am.
If you have two, then that will increase to at least 34. Is
yes,
that
ma'am.
Correct?
That's correct, ma'am.
So from 6, from 8, you can go to 34 at least.
Tama po kayo, ma'am. Yes.
So, sir,
we will conduct the feasibility study. As sabi nga po ni Sec, we are now also in the process for decentralization of the purchase of the DepEd computerization program.
Okay.
Simulan po na.
Ilan po ang natenggang computer sa warehouses?
Ilan po? Ma'am, yung 2020 to 2021. May we refer you sa KU Secrebsi po.
Madam Chair, good afternoon. Yung procurement ng DCP or yung computer packages for 2020 to 2021, around 70,327 DCP packages, but na-hold na po yan and na-deliver to school since December of 2023. Ang natitira na lang po ay 755 smart TVs and 900 laptops dun sa warehouse ng Transpac po.
Have you investigated kung anong dahilan kung bakit nagkaroon ng ganitong problema?
May ongoing investigation po.
Hindi pa natutukoy kung sino ang may dahilan kung bakit nagkaroon ng ganitong problema?
Maybe we can ask our legal to... They're the ones who did, with your permission, Madam Chair, Yusek Romero, for legal.
Yep.
They have the investigation. They have done the investigation.
Good afternoon, Madam Chair. For the Transpac matter, this is the third-party logistics provider. We have initiated to date the termination proceedings of the for the unfulfilled parts of the contract.
Yeah, Madam Chair, I believe Yusek Umar is not being responsive. Ang tanong ko po is, dun sa investigation po ninyo, na itukoy nyo na po ba kung sino po ang naging source of problem within DepEd?
Just to clarify, Madam Chair, there has been, as far as legal is concerned, there has been no investigation on the Transpac contract. But what we were directed to previously was to initiate the termination proceedings on the unfulfilled portions of the contract.
So, tingin ko, Sec, of course, termination is one thing, pero sa tingin ko, investigation is another thing. Somebody has to be accountable for this. I think it's a very big problem. Somebody has to be accountable. And sa katunayan, kanina pa namin tinitignan ng numero, so merong 8 billion for 2024 appropriated for computers. Meron kayong 12 billion na hinihingi for next year. Paano naman po namin susuportahan yung ganyan kung may ganito pong problema? So, ang hirap eh, di ba? Of course, we really want to support all your requests, pero kung hindi naman po natin ma-absorb, napakaliit po na. Pasensya na po, Director, ha? Pero 2 minutes pa lang, eh, ang dami na pong suggestions dito. Alam niyo po si Chairman, napakasipag po. Weekly po kami mag-meeting ng committee. Hindi po kami naubusan ng pag-recommend ng suggestions. Kayo po ba sa DepEd? Ganon din po ba? Kasipag mag-execom? Gano po ka-regular ang... Kahit doon sa previous,
Since I've taken over, ma'am, I've been in office six weeks, we have one execom every
now, week. What about previously, sir?
Maybe we can ask the members of the execom who can answer how often, or the anyone, I guess, from the undersecretaries, Yusek Karevsi,
Since the assumption of the vice president, nung 2022 regular at least a month, but the last execom that we had July 2023.
Sorry, once a semester.
Execom.
You're talking about the execom.
Execom with the secretary.
Oh, I mean, on the average.
Meron kaming execom.
Is it regular? Yes or no?
Yes, regular. But since July
no, so
of 2023,
regular is it
cluster meetings
how frequent po?
Yung cluster meetings.
No. The execom.
The execom during 2022 and first half of 2023, twice a month.
Twice a month. So it's not as regular as...
As
is it this today?
The current, yes, opo.
Twice a month. Okay. Going back to the slide, pwede po ba natin balikan isa-isa? Kasi pagdating naman sa new classrooms, naka-indicate 4,071 new classrooms, but based on the audit report, ang nakasulat ay only 192 out of 6,379 ang completed in 2023. So that's my next question. How did we jump from 192 to 4,071 in August of 2024?
With your permission, ma'am, we'll ask Yusek Densing to report on that.
And siguro ipapagpatuloy ko na, Sec, naka-indicate 1985 classrooms repaired and constructed, but based on the 2023 report, only 208 classrooms were completed of the 7,550 classrooms targeted for repair and rehab of classrooms for 2023.
Yes.
So, paano po nag-jump from 208 to 1985 in a matter of 8 months? Of course, again, if it's a miracle, we'll applaud.
Yeah, Madam Chair, Your Honor, it includes spillover. So, sa 2023, it's 100.
Spillover
from previous years.
So, again, how far along? 1965?
2019 to 2022, may spillover po. So, out of the 192, of the 5,133 targeted for 2023, 192 was constructed, and kasama spillover from the previous years, 2,743. For 2024, hindi pa po nag-start yung ongoing po karamihan, spillover is 1,136 for a total 4,071. Your Honor, Madam Chair, majority of the 2023 school buildings were multi-story, so we do not really expect them to be finished within the usual 120 to 150 days. So it's usually maabot po ng 240 to 70 days, and some contractors lumalampas ng 360 for those 3-story to 4-story buildings. So we expect a lot of new construction from 2023 to be constructed by the end of 2024, spilled over, Madam Chair, Your Honor.
So could you kindly just resubmit this slide to make clear what you had accomplished by year? Kasi nakaka mislead itong slide na to. It's as if these were all accomplished within the year. So nakakagulat po kasi tinitingnan naman po natin kasi yung 2023 report na syempre nakakagulat na biglang all of a sudden nagkaroon ng vast improvement within 8 months. So paki-resubmit na lang po ito, at baka naman kasi nabubudol din si Secretary, nagugulat na in 8 months lahat ito nagawa. So para rin naman ma-brief properly si Secretary.
We will furnish, Madam Chair.
Yes po. Pagdating naman po sa textbooks, nakasulat dito 30 million something procured. Pero again, pagdating dito sa 2023 COA report, just to put on record, Madam Chair, naka-indicate po dito, unutilized funds for textbooks, 460.3 million of 605.4 million approved budget for contracts. So there's a huge unutilized funds for textbooks. So can you please explain kung sino po ang naka-assign po for textbooks?
I think maybe Yusek Gonong or Yusek Chan would know. Yeah.
Yusek Gonong, you're recognized.
Thank you, Sec. Madam Chair, noon pong 2023, ang mga pinrocure po namin ay, ma'am, senior high school textbooks po, kasi hindi pa po tayo nagpo-procure ng K-10. So yung senior high school textbooks po, nagka-problema po kami sa procurement. Kaya hindi po namin na-procure lahat ng kailangan para sa senior high school. So bidding po uli ang problema ng ating mga senior high school textbooks.
So may problema ang malaki sa bidding. So again, pabalik tayo dito sa malaking perang hinihingi po natin, at lahat po kami dito talagang we want to support the increase in your budget. So again, anong gagawin natin para i-absorb lahat po yan?
Madam Chair, Your Honor, kaya po ngayong taon, umpisahan po namin yung early procurement activity. Tapos, we're also moving towards decentralization of procurement.
Okay. Pero itong number na to, you confirm that this is that's achievement or accomplishment for this year alone?
Yes po.
For
yes,
this
po.
Year alone?
Yes po.
Sige po. So, pa-advise na lang po ng slide na to all those USECs concerned na to reflect the years. Okay po. Next po is para sa insurance. Meron po tayong nilaan na 2 billion pesos. Ginastos po natin yung 2 billion pesos. Binayad natin sa GSIS. I'm sure si Sec Sonny knows this. Dahil siya po ang finance chair up to recently. Because of that premiums, entitled po tayo sa repair. So ngayong dumaan ng Karina, na-check na po ba natin ang repairs, at tayo po ba ay nakapag-file na ng claim against
this
fund?
Yes, Your Honor. And Yusek Escobedo knows the details.
Yes, and paki-special mention po, Marikina. I just want to know po kung nakapag-claim tayo.
Yung Marikina po ay may isasubmit kaming list sa BTR. Dahil yung unang list po na nasubmit natin covers 5 regions, CAR, Regions 1, 2, 3, and 4A, total of 156 schools. Yung second list, mga NCR schools po. And we talk to the BTR na may ihahabol po kaming schools, particularly po, isa po dun yung Marikina, yung Nangka High School. because ang Nangka High School mayroong 34 classrooms totally damaged worth 85 million and 28 classrooms na partially damaged na 14 million, a total of 99 million. Isasubmit po namin yan sa BTR and we informed the BTR about this, ma'am.
So only so partially and totally damaged
classrooms, opo. So, and meron pa po kaming pinapakiusap sa BTR kasi school buildings lang po ang kino-cover ng NNIP. Kung pwede, pati school furnitures, since integrated naman po na essential component po ang school furniture sa building.
Okay, may tanong ako. Actually, I wanted to ask si Wick Veloso directly. Nabanggit ninyo kanina solar panels. Pwede nyo bang i-push na isama na ang solar panels dito sa mga i-rehabilitate? Sa tingin ko, sa laki ng binayad natin na 2 billion, kasi halimbawa, for Marikina alone, we are entitled to 4.312 billion worth of insurance claims para lamang sa taong 2024. So, baka naman sakaling, hindi ko alam kung baka sakaling kayang ma... I'm not sure kung pwede,
but
you can inquire.
We will inquire. But definitely, I think that's part of the new design of some of the classrooms in unelectrified areas.
Because that will clearly, the schools will be able to save a lot on the MOOE because a big chunk of that is used for Meralco bills. I-check nyo lang, baka sakali.
Yes, Your Honor.
Baka sakali.
Yes, Madam Chair.
Okay. Sec, what are your thoughts on K-12? We've asked this question many, many, many times during our committee hearings. Ang sagot sa amin is, you are still reviewing K-12. It's sad, Sec, that we rolled it out without a proper impact evaluation, unlike 4Ps, which we did that properly. Ito nagmadali. Pinasok natin. You showed a slide earlier. Only 20% of senior high school students are now working. Of course, we don't know ilan ba talaga ang nag-take ng TVL among senior high school students, but I think a big chunk of SHS students took TVL. I'm not sure. I think maybe half. So, if half is the base, madami pa rin ang hindi nakahanap ng trabaho. So, anong thoughts ninyo dito? Ako, offhand, if it did not work, are you open to actually at grade 10, bakit hindi natin sila bigyan ng pagkakataon to take the college entrance exam? And if they qualify, why can't they go to college? And yung sigurado na gusto nilang mag-TVL, bakit hindi natin palakasin ang test, mag-gumawa ng test the classrooms within the schools themselves? Para ma-strengthen ang senior high school. So, your thoughts, sir?
Thank you, Madam Chair. I think that's a good idea to benefit our learners. My worry is they'll be discriminated against when they go abroad. Because that was one of the arguments made when we passed the Cape. I was here in this chamber at the time. The father of the Senate President was the chair of basic education. I was the chair of higher education when we passed the expanded or the K-12 reform. And they were telling us that our engineers were not being hired as engineers abroad because they didn't have a 12-year basic exam. Even if they had finished the 4 or 5-year engineering degree, they would look at their basic education. It would be 10 years. And they would hire them as engineering assistants rather than engineers. So these were some of the issues raised that why we needed to go to 12 years, Madam Chair. But having said that, I think it's been very poorly implemented in the years since we passed the reform. Your colleagues here, Madam Chair, have mentioned the unfulfilled promises, yung pangako na magkakatrabaho sila, yung pangako na they will be able to earn a living wage to support their families. That hasn't really materialized because as mentioned by Chairman Roman, NC1, NC2 sila. NC2 is novice. Hindi nila makukuha yung minimum wage sa NC2. So, we need to work on it. Unfortunately, there was a lot of political jockeying for inclusion in the senior high school curriculum at the time, in 2016, that it became everyone threw in the kitchen sink. All the professions wanted to ibababa sa general studies ng college, binaba lahat. So now we require 15 courses of all 4 tracks of senior high school. So magtitivet ang bata, magka-college ang bata, magsa-sports or arts track ang bata. They have to take 15 classes. And to illustrate, someone na papasok to become a baker or a to work in hotel and restaurant will have to take pananaliksik sa Pilipino. Kumbaga, hindi na relevant dun sa kanyang kukunin. Kaya ang direction namin dyan, ay nadatnan ko na po, may study ang ADB jointly with DepEd and may recommendations po yan. That was given to me a few weeks ago. But the planned rollout is 2026 to 27 pa. So, sabi ko, kawawa naman yung ating mga senior high school na they will have to deal with this cluttered curriculum which is not responsive to the needs of employers in the next 2 years. So, I've ordered that we do the review, we fast track the review, and we roll it out in 2025 to 26. I realize this will be very challenging, Madam Chair, because we have to change the materials, we have to train our teachers, and all the accompanying actions kasama po nitong pagbago ng curriculum. But we need to, because ako po, when I did my A-levels in the UK, we only had 4 subjects for 2 years. Yung mga anak natin na nagbaccalaureate, Kong Len, yourself, they play studied in schools where they probably have an international type of curriculum. Mga 8 subjects lang ho yan eh. Sa Australia, 6 subjects lang ho yan. Sa Amerika, ganun din ho. And tayo, 15. So, and yung work immersion natin, 80 to 320 hours. Pero ang hinihingi ng industriya, 640 hours. So we need to declutter the curriculum, provide electives that the kids can really, they're at an age where they really can choose their own destiny. So we just provide them with the basics, I think. Reading and writing, a little bit of math, a little bit of science, a little bit of history, a little bit of physical education, a little bit of civics, good manners and right conduct. Yun na yun. I think, Madam Chair, pag yun ang binigay natin, then we give electives and then we give the work immersion. Tapos, one suggestion is for the sports and arts track, which comprise less than 1% or 1% of the universe of senior high school students. Eh, dapat i-fold in natin sa academic track to provide a specialization. The way we provide a STEM specialization or an accounting and business specialization, we have a specialization for arts, we have a specialization for sports. Kasi the data shows that yung mga graduates nung tracks na ito, go on to general education anyway. They go on to college anyway. So, these are some of the ideas, ma'am. Medyo hilaw pa, lulutuin pa namin yung talaga. Pero minamadali na po namin dahil ayaw namin na there will be more kids under this burdensome curriculum which is not responsive to the needs of our students. It's not responsive also to the needs of our employers, Madam Chair.
Well, thanks. But just 2 points. One is, we have the highest number of dropouts at third year college. I'm not sure if you know that, but nakahagulat, right? At which also means sinasayang natin ng pera sa UACTE. Ibig sabihin, so nakakapagtaga, di ba? Para sa akin, one possible interpretation of that is many did not really intend to finish college. They just wanted to find a job. But at the point where they finished senior high school, they just couldn't find a job. And so they went to college anyway because it's free in SUCs and LUCs. And then once they took 2 years, because 2 years of college makes you eligible for a job, and then they dropped out of college. So ang dami natin nasasayang na pera din sa UACTE. So yun ang mga palaisipan. So kung naayos talaga natin ang K-12, ang dami natin natitipid na pera pagdating sa UACTE. And at the same time, natutulungan natin ang mga bata to get themselves matched to their dream jobs. So yun po. And at the same time po, yung kulang sa years of schooling, palagay ko, if we are able to improve our quality tremendously, tingin ko makikita yon ng lahat ng industriya sa buong mundo. And you don't even have to justify why you're only in school for X number of years. If ang PISA rankings natin napakataas, you will not even question why we only have that number of years in school. Next question po is sa SPED. Are we still going to insist upon our ILRC? Which, to be honest with you, I'm not sure if it works. Because in Marikina, I've not seen an ILRC. Meanwhile, ang dami-dami pong SPED na kabataan na talagang nangangailangan talaga ng interventions na na totoo. Pasensya na po ha, but it's they don't get properly assessed. Assessment na lang hindi na kayang i-provide. And yun po, wala talaga silang mapuntahan. Ang dami pong PhilHealth benefits, yung Z benefit, there's a Z benefit package amounting to 50,000 pesos under PhilHealth, but that is hardly used. So yun po, ang daming pera ng gobyerno. Bakit pa tayo gumagawa ng ILRC na hindi ko maintindihan kung ano yun, na hindi naman yata kayang ma-implement?
Thank you for the question, Madam Chair. The ILRC is mandated by the Inclusive Education Law that we convert the existing SPEDs or Special Education Centers, ma'am. The idea there is that the ILRC acts like a sort of like a fulcrum or to serve a large area. Parang in the way the library hub is also meant to serve the schools within a certain area. So they have complete facilities, complete services. But of course, on the ground, hindi talaga, nagkukulang ho talaga dahil kulang tayo ng mga professionals, special education professionals. We cannot even diagnose correctly because of the lack of development pediatricians. Madam Chair, this is not exclusive to the public school sector, but it's a private sector. Some of our children had to wait a year, 2 years to get an appointment with a development pediatrician. So again, just like this is one where we need to coordinate with just like the issue of the guidance counselors, of the science teachers, we have to coordinate with the other education bodies like CHED so that we give scholarships to the badly needed professions and courses or studies that are needed in our school system, Madam Chair.
So it's going to be as is. No, we're not going to.
We're open, ma'am, to any suggestions. We have to do that, the conversion of the ILRCs, because it is a provision of law under the Inclusive Education Act. But we're open to any suggestions or innovations from the body, Your Honor.
But Madam Chair, well, we don't have one in Marikina that works. I'm just saying that meanwhile, ang dami talagang nangangailangan na SPED, and we also have private therapy centers, small ones, and they all come to me, ask for help. The only thing that I can provide is like the SWD assistance, etc., which is kulang talaga. Meanwhile, there's this huge fund called PhilHealth, and they have Z benefit packages, but then amounting to 50,000 a year per head, which is hardly tapped because for lack of coordination. So I think that's something that whoever is assigned, kung pwede sana, kausapin nyo, that's a lot of, I mean, there's a lot on my plate. I can do it, but may trabaho din ako. But sana, you, please, that's something that can actually potentially solve your problem.
That's a very good suggestion, ma'am. As for the SPED Center, maybe we can, some of our schools go to Carmona, the district of Congressman Loyola. That's considered a model a SPED center. They have all the facilities and they started early. They have complete staff and the ratio of professionals to learners is 1:3, if I'm not mistaken. So it's really very good, very positive. And they even have a little coffee shop where they employ the graduates of their special education. And the city also employs the graduates of the SPED center. So it's a whole ecosystem, Madam Chair. Not just a school producing, churning out graduates. So.
Yes. For internet connectivity, you indicated that you needed 9.2 billion. Is that your full, will that allow you to fully connect all your schools? Because right now, how many schools are connected? I believe it's less than 20%. Is 9.2 billion sufficient for 100% connection?
Your Honor, currently we are at 69% of our school are connected into the internet.
Is it 69?
Yes, pero albeit very limited connection. Usually in the faculty room, computer room, or faculty.
Mababa po yung bandwidth
nun. Mababa po yung
director,
bandwidth.
Sorry, Director. Ha? Kanina sabi mo, one computer for 9 students. Mm. For the life of me, parang hindi ako maniniwala, sir. Sabi niyo, one computer to 30 teachers, one computer to 9 students. Hindi ko alam paano niyo kinocompute yan. Is it for only for students that are requiring computer classes and therefore in the computer lab? Because it doesn't sound right, ha, sir. So, okay, paki-recompute yung number na yan because hindi po ako naniniwala sa datos na yan. So, if you tell me that 69% of schools are connected, parang hindi rin po ako maniwala.
Okay, ma'am. We will...
Kasi sa last time I checked, it's about 20, low 20s.
Low 20%.
Sige, actually, ma'am, tama ho sila, Madam Chair. The computer-to-learner ratio is 1 is to 23 for elementary. It's 1 is to 8 for junior high school. 1 is to 5 for senior high school.
On average.
That's the computer-learner ratio. Doon naman ho sa schools with internet connectivity. Tama yung figure po cited by Director Pitagan. Pero karamihan nga, yung connectivity is only limited to the administrative and faculty offices. So hindi, it's not the type we envision that there is a computer lab. Parang binibilang na isang room lang, may there's a few computers and the maybe the principal and their assistant have the internet access. Bilang na po yun sa 69.
Yes, so, no, Sec, I'm trying to offer a solution kasi the ICT is mandated by law to provide free Wi-Fi to including public schools. And right now, the balance of the Spectrum Fund is 21 billion. And what we're saying, we've already asked them to commit to us and we've taught them how to actually tap that fund. So we've told them to of course prioritize public schools. Pero syempre, sabi ko, the hell idea namin yan, unahin na Marikina. No, but so sir, itong so they told me about this 9.2 billion. Pero sabi ko, definitely magkukulang yan. So dapat po again, please coordinate with them. So meron pong malaking pondo to please make sure at wag lang po yung small areas na yan, pero lahat po dapat, yung buong school. Yan ang target po natin na lahat po sila dapat mabigyan ng connection. At yun na nga, kung sana po mapaipakita po ninyo na kaya po ninyo makapag-procure at makapag-deliver ng maayos ng computers, edi sana, di ba, mas maiisip po namin talagang makapag-appropriate tayo ng pondo para sa computers. Lahat ng bata magkaroon ng computer and at the same time, connection po.
It's well taken, Madam Chair.
Sorry, last na lang po. Are you reviewing your policy in determining MOOE budgets for schools?
Yes, ma'am. There's an ADB study which studied the Bongkodin formulas. As the name indicates, it's a long time vintage because patay na po si Secretary Bongkodin. But the Bongkodin formula took four variables: the number of learners, the number of teachers, the number of graduates, into the number of classrooms into account in determining the MOOE. So four factors lang yun. And then may fixed and variable cost po. The new ADB formula takes into account 27 variables. And so there's a... 600. Yeah, but what are the 27? Yung kailangan kung may janitor, may wash facilities, may computer. So it's a more holistic index, Your Honor.
Yeah, yung sa akin lang naman, Sec, is kasi I think...
Tingin ko, tataas ko yung MOE. The net result is tataas ko ang MOE.
Tataas sana. At sana hindi ito ang maging dahilan kung bakit parang napipilitan lahat, napipilitan ang school head na ipasa lahat ng estudyante. Kasi, Siyempre gusto naman natin sila pumasa. Pero minsan kasi, kahit na hindi dapat pumasa, ipinapasa dahil nakabase sa number of students ang MOOE. So, tama ba ako na yun ang isang nagiging factor? Ay, hindi ko alam kung tama yung aking pag-analyze kasi parang nakikita ko na...
You're correct, ma'am. It was a factor.
But now, it's been factor, removed. Diba?
Hindi na po factor. You're
so,
correct.
So, di ba, parang pag nakikita natin na parang yung performance ay yun, parang hindi nagiging...
Say perverse incentive po.
Yes, sana nagiging mas reflective yung nare-reflect yung totoong performance nung. So yun po. So thank you
for... It's partially reflected. Hindi po in full reflected because hindi kaya nung we proposed it in the 2025 but hindi na reflect. But it's partially reflected though in the school MOE because the president gave us one day to order. I had one day to review the budget. So that was the change I made to increase the MOE of the schools, Madam Chair.
Yes, isa na lang pabaon for round 2, just one. I asked the NEET scores. I've been asking the NEET scores since way back and finally binigay sa akin a few months ago. If anyone, I'm going to ask it about the NEET scores. kung pwede sana, if any one of you had cared to look at it, need score sa NCR for round 2. Salamat po.
Thank you. Thank you very much, ma'am.